The Deputy Information Minister Pius Hajide says the corruption index report is not a parameter to measure the performance of political appointees. The attacks by the opposition party are deliberate, he says, attempts to discredit efforts by government, which is equipping institutions financially, as well as embarking on a digitization program to reduce corruption.
We must appreciate the latest CPI release in the context in which the statement was released. This essentially attempts to measure electoral integrity, politics, money and corruption, and if you may, corruption in general in the public space. And so to illustrate, if there's a perception that some police people can take money to allow cars that are not roadworthy to be on the streets, or that there's some perception that some member of the judicial service can take some bribe to prolong a case. These are all the issues of corruption in the public space. A lot of the commentary that I've heard seeks to suggest as though this perception index is a measure of political appointee corruption, and that can be very misleading, and we need to correct it from the very onset. However, government has continued to increase allocations to the anti-graft agencies. If you go to the ports, the DVLA, to the passport office, and so on and so forth, you notice that now there is an aggressive digitization exercise that is ongoing there with a view to eliminating the human factor, which is a major case or a major point in the fight against corruption. What is out there, a lot of it is mere propaganda, a lot of it is fabrications and unsubstantiated allegations. But the strategy for any student of Joseph Goebbels, as the NDC and their surrogates are, their modus operandi is that let us throw these falsehoods in and let us repeat it, and over time people will come to accept it.